One thing that the lockdown has done for all of us is it has allowed us to take a break whenever we want, because all my sessions have been happening from a remote location. So it doesn't matter. My listener doesn't care from where I'm doing a talk show, right? So if I'm, whether I'm recording videos or whether I'm talking to people about in a meeting, when I'm doing any of those things, people don't really care where I am. So I think it allows you to take vacations. And yes, if it's real hard work, then what happens is you won't find much time to do anything else. So then there is no point in traveling 2000 kilometers or 1500 kilometers, going to a place and locking yourself in a room and working 12 hours a day. Like, there are people who work that long hours. For those people, it does hardly matters, because you're incurring extra cost of traveling, of staying in a different location. In a homestay, what happens is we get control over the kitchen, we get control over everything else. Yes, we have to pay a little more, we have to pay rent, whereas in our own house, we don't have to. But it's a great way to get a change of scenery, and people like me don't work too much, I mean, maybe an hour or two in a day. So that gives us a lot of time to go around, move around, look at the place, and we can always choose. Like right now, the choice is I'm in the mountains. This place is near Chandigarh. It's in Himachal Pradesh. Chandigarh is the closest airport. So yes, you can do those kind of things. And next week, I could be in Goa. Recording from there, you don't really care whether there are waves behind me or this water. If you hear the water, there is a waterfall and there is a river gushing. Is it too big a river? No, but it has rained in the last couple of days, which means the water is full, and therefore the noise. You can hear some pitter patter also of the rain. Today there's no rain, it's a clear sky, and will you believe it, I'm recording this at about 5:30 in the morning, and it is bright and sunny. So, you know, it allows you these kind of things. Homestays are a great place to visit. I think there are homestay clubs happening in on Facebook. You could just join there and find where are the good homestays available. A, homestays give you home food. Homestays give you don't give you room service. Very rarely will you get room service. There are lesser number of people. You meet interesting people, and travel anyway broadens your mind. And how I decided to come to Himachal Pradesh was very simple. I applied for e-pass, which you require to move from Chandigarh to Himachal Pradesh, and I got it in 45 minutes. I realized that you know, things are opening up, and immediately a friend hires an homestay here. So I decided to come. Staying in a friend's homestay does not really change anything with you to cost, but a few of us came here, so it's good fun to be with friends, family, whoever can travel. And I think this is a good, one of the better things which has happened because of COVID. We would never have thought of doing these things. Now I can do these things permanently, right? I like to travel, I like to take vacations, I like to go on treks and hikes, and I also record on finance. So only my attire will change a little bit. Yeah, you cannot see the books in the background, but you can still see my face, you can see my cap, you can see the place where I'm staying. And let me tell you, none of these posts are paid for posts. It's just that I thought that it's a good place to be. This is a small homestay with a capacity of just 15 people. So it's not that he requires any publicity. He's very happy with the level at which he is. He has very close to 100% occupancy. Another great thing about JB, which is good for him from a homestay point of view, is that it is a place where throughout the year there can be some activity. You can come in January and do some snow. You can come in May, June, and it's a peak summer where it goes to about 25 degrees. So it's not really a summer, right? Then sometime in July, August, there is monsoon. You can do monsoon treks, you can do monsoon forest walks. That's only for the brave, because it's not easy getting wet at 8,000 feet and 10,000 feet, because you will start shivering. So unless you're very well equipped with maybe your ponchos and your wind cheaters and all the perfectly correct equipment, which is all available online, then you can come and do those things. So this kind of choice and variety is something which we could have explored even without COVID, but we never did it. And pre-COVID, nobody accepted that I could do a session online. I had to fly to so many places. No, I'm not cribbing about it. I still love my live sessions much better than I like my sessions, which are because I can't interact with you, right? So I prefer a training which is physical rather than a training which is online. But I'm doing online training and I'm enjoying doing the online training. What I love about online training is it reaches the remotest part. I can, when I do a session in Delhi, at best I can expect people to come from Gurgaon and Noida. But when I do one session for a mutual fund or for a pharma company for North India, which means there is more Hindi, I can get people from Patiala, Ludhiana, Kurukshetra, Chandigarh, you know, every stop from Delhi to Chandigarh can give you 3, 5, 10 people. I can get people from Srinagar, I can get people from Shillong, I can get a full range of people. My class would have 40 people, but my online sessions have 480 people. I did some sessions for Nippon, I did some sessions for a couple of pharma companies. They may not be very keen that I name them, but I've done training sessions for Nippon, I've done training sessions for Aditya Birla Mutual Fund. It is nice to reach through audience, nice to reach to audience which I think knows me. Maybe they know me, maybe they don't know me, but when the invite is sent out by the mutual fund, it goes to a lot of smaller geographies where I would never reach physically because it would not be worthwhile. I don't think any mutual fund does much training in, say, Srinagar. It may not have enough audience to justify that. I may do it in Chandigarh, but I don't think north of Chandigarh too much of training I have done. I don't think I've gone much north of Chandigarh. Yes, I've done a training for a government organization in Srinagar, but that was so far back. Similarly, northeast, you cannot, you just stop at Guwahati. You don't go beyond Guwahati. And it is impossible for people to come from various distances, right? You can't come for a 3-hour lecture, spending a whole day or coming in a more expensive mode of transport. So that way, I think there are advantages, there are disadvantages, but Corona told us that you can reach every Indian house or whoever is interested in, I mean, by a medium called visual medium, and thanks to the connectivity by 2-3 Indian companies, magnificent connectivity in a place like GP. So work from home or a workation really works, and I think that's a great thing to have happened because people have accepted. We were forced to accept, and once you're forced to accept, you will accept it, and then you find that wow, this works well. So I'm not saying that physical training in a classroom is going to disappear, but I think both will happen, and the costs go down dramatically for a fund house. There's no travel cost, there's no stay cost, there's nothing. So they're perhaps likely to pump in more money and do more training and reach more people on more topics, and they could use a variety of people. They could use a fund manager, they could use a sales guy, they could use a CEO. For example, I would love some CEOs to talk about how to be positive during bad times. I mean, there are CEOs who have achieved that, right? So those kind of talks, and YouTube has a huge array of products which you can watch. You can watch yoga, you can watch exercise, you can watch cooking, right? It has forced us to explore, and so many videos are available. Go learn, have fun, and take your vacations. Thank you.